Hey guys, it's Marcus Maloney, the Equity King, and I'm excited about talking with you today. Real brief, I want to talk about just a few things that I found that has been useful in my life to bring me to where I am today. But before we get started, you know, I just want to let you know, if this is your first time here, this channel is all about the intricacies of real estate wholesaling and real estate investing. I am a real estate wholesaler. I am a property investor. I own multifamily homes and single family homes. Also, if you're looking for great content to help you get started, you can go to equityrealestateblog.com. That's equityrealestateblog.com. We have contracts, assignment agreements, you know, plenty of things there for you. So please come on over, check me out, check us out, and see what we have to offer. And then again, you can reach us on Facebook at Equity Realty Investments, and on Instagram, my personal Instagram, MRCS Maloney at Instagram. So let's go ahead and kind of get started. What I want to look at today is just some of the things that I can reflect and look back that helped me get to where I am. We're coming to the close of the year, you know, and at the close of the year, people want to reflect and look back. You know, what did I do this year that really helped me stand out, helped me be successful? Or what are some of the things that I did that didn't help me be successful? So I want to talk about those things. And then with that, you know, there's a big misconception that people say, hey, man, in order for you to be successful, you got to be a shark. You got to always be on an attack. You got to grind it out. You got to work, you know, 200 hours a week, so on and so forth. Although some of those things are true, you know, you have to definitely be diligent in your work. You have to work plenty of hours, you know, to get things off the ground. In order for you to get started, you know, it's not going to start immediately. You have to put work into it. So getting started today, I was just kind of looking back on some of the things that I had to do to take me from where I was, you know, basically having nothing and moving across country, you know, promised a job and that job was pulled out from up under me and my family not having much, to where I am now. I'm here in my home office where I do a lot of my work, plenty of deals and things here, and talking to you. So one of the things that really take me to where I am, that brought me to where I am now, is I had to shift my mind from being a me guy to being a help. You know, I had to open up my mind and see the big picture and see how I could help others, especially in real estate wholesaling. You know, we always look at, you know, what's going to be my end profit, but that end profit is going to be zero unless you help that seller, you know, alleviate that problem that they're having. So you have to be mindful. How can I help this seller? How can I help this person, you know, get rid of this situation and move on to the next area in their life? So number one basically is you have to see the big picture and you have to be able to help others. Number two is education. Not only education for yourself, but education for those that are around you. I'm an avid reader. I read quite a bit. And not only that, I help to educate people around me. And then again, I'm going to speak specifically to real estate wholesaling because I do real estate wholesaling, and that helped me buy my multifamily homes, is that I have to educate my seller on exactly what they need. I'll give you an example. On today, I spoke with the seller and their whole mindset was, if I can't get $120,000 for my house, then I'll just do the rehab myself. And I had to educate the seller and I said, Mr. Seller, you know what? It looks like you're going to need to put at least 80 to 100 grand in the house in order for you to sell it for $200,000. We're going in the winter. Holding that property over the winter can be a monster, plus getting those permits and finding the right people to do the rehab. So evidently, we didn't get the deal, but we did educate that seller, and I told that seller, you know what? I'll follow up with you, and if things don't go according to plan, I'm always here as a backup for you. So just by educating that seller and building that rapport with that seller, I don't know if we're going to get the deal or not, but we know that we have that door of opportunity still available to speak with that seller. Okay. And then the next thing that I learned. So number two was education. So one was help. Two was educate. Three is consistency. Everything that you do, you have to be consistent at it. Even within your education, even within my reading, you know, I try and consistently read something every morning to inspire me to get started on my day. It may seem like something little, but I can definitely tell a difference from when I don't do that to when I do that. You have to be your own critic. You have to be your own greatest critic. You know, you look at the end of the day, if you didn't get everything accomplished that you plan to get accomplished, there is a reason why. You have to look back and see what that reason is. You know, especially when you're working a home-based business, it's easy to get distracted. You know, so you have to be consistent in what you're doing. And then lastly, is relationships. You have to be a people person. You have to build those relationships. You have to get out. Now is a good time. We're at the end of the year. Everybody's going to be throwing holiday parties, corporate holiday parties. So you have to get out there and you have to engage and get with people and let them know exactly what you're doing. So real briefly, I just wanted to tell you that as we're wrapping up the year, you know, some of the things that I reflect and look back on to help me get to where I am. One was helping others. Two was educating myself and those around me. Three was being consistent in everything that I do. Four is building those relationships. So remember, money is a good thing, but money is not the only thing. You know, you have to have drivers to get you where you're trying to go. And I believe these four things that I introduced and outlined for you today will definitely help you get there. So I'm Marcus Maloney, the Equity King, signing off. Again, remember, if you want some great information, some great articles and content, go to equityrealestateblog.com. And then if this helped you out, please comment, like, let me know what other information I can provide for you. All right. Have a wonderful holiday if I don't speak to you again, and I look forward to engaging with you. Oh, lastly, don't forget, as a holiday gift, I'm doing the free 30-minute consultation. So come on, you know, go to the link below. Get your 30-minute free consultation on how you can get started as a real estate investor.